Area is a product and it is a sum, so I went ahead and color-coded the boxes, just like we would with our tiles themselves. So just to identify these, this far left bottom box that we have looks like it's that light blue color, and it's got the same dimension on each side. So this is going to be an x squared tile. Then right next to it, both above and off to the right-hand side, has that still same x dimension, but it's got that 1 on the side. So these are all going to be x tiles as well, both top and to the right. And then this top right corner, those dark blue tiles are single tiles, so these are going to be each 1. So I figured the first one that we would do was do the area as a sum. Area as a sum, you just total up how many of the different tiles that you have. So in this case, we have 1x squared, but the 1's not necessary, so we can just call it x squared. Plus, none of the sides are showing red, so nothing's negative here. Looks like I have 5x's, totaling up all of them. And then up in that right-hand corner, looks like I have 6 singles. Okay, so there is my area as a sum. Now, let's go ahead and use a different color to go around the sides. And I'm going to try to avoid colors that we are using for our tiles. I don't think we're using orange, so let's go ahead and stick with orange. When we are talking about the area as a product, we want to talk about the dimension. So going back to this x squared tile, I know that the dimensions both on the bottom and the side of the x squared tile is x. Then looking across the bottom, it looks like the short side of the x tile is showing, which means those are all 1's. Likewise, if I go up the left-hand side, the short side of the x tile is also showing, and those are all 1's. So my job to be able to find the area as a product is to add up everything on the going up and add up going across the bottom. Remember that the area is going to be base times height because this is a rectangle. So the base of this, I'm going to have an x, and then I've got 3 units, so plus 3, times the height is going to be x, and then it looks like I'm going to have 2 singles going up. So there is my area as a product and area as a sum. Let's go ahead and do the same thing on question number 2. So I'll go ahead and take out the black marker again to fill in what we have. Now a green tile, that's an xy tile. The big purple tiles, those are y squared. And then likewise, the purple tiles, those are y tiles. And then those blues, those are the same ones from the first example, those are x's. So area as a sum. Well, normally we try to do some sort of descending order or even ascending order, but we've got some mixture of variables in here. So let's go ahead and start with the y squared. I'm going to start with the squared first, and then I'm going to work my way down on the y's, and I have 2 y's. Then I'm going to introduce that combination tile, which is the xy, and then I'll bring in those 2 x's. So just trying to organize it a little bit. Again, as long as all of the values that you have are the same, it doesn't really matter what order it's in. All right, let's go back to this. Now, going across the bottom, I know that the long blue part on the x tile is x, and the long purple on the purple tile is y. Again, nothing red is showing. And then going up, I've got my 2 blues. Well, those are each going to be 1's because it's the short side showing. Then taking a look at this xy tile, you'll notice based off of the picture that it's the long side that's showing on the outside. Well, the long side is the y. So now that I've got my dimensions for my base and my height, I know that my base is x plus y times my height for this object is going to be y plus 2. So I have my area as a sum and my area as a product.